What's up, guys? Curse Man here. Doing a quick package video. Good buddy Ben sent me a package in the mail yesterday, and got them. And I'm going to show y'all what I got. It's just some things that I didn't get on my list last week, and actually some of these are from a couple weeks ago, and a little bit longer than that, I think. But he was nice enough to pick them up for me and held them in his box for me. And then shipped them out yesterday, so, and he threw in a couple extra stuff too, so it was really cool. Music in the background is going to be a couple different things, probably just on my iTunes shuffle right now. It sounds like Counting Crows. We can't go wrong there. First book I'm going to show you is probably my favorite out of this whole stack. It's like the art and the story. I'm going to take it out of the package just to show you guys, but this guy gets plenty of hate throughout the community, but this story and the art in this book are, to me, just amazing. I loved it. I mean, it was so awesome. It's a two-part series about Boom Studios, and the writer for this was, let's see, Paul Jenkins, and the art is by Umberto Ramos. So yeah, I know y'all cringe, some of y'all cringe when you hear that name, but I don't see anything wrong with the guy's art. It's freaking amazing. It's called Fairy Quest. They have a variant cover for this. I think Ben got it, and it was a black and white sketch cover with the big wolf there. And this thing is so awesome. I mean, the art in here is freaking just amazing. Let me flip to a couple cool pages with, like, the wolf is my favorite part. He is so badass looking. A couple scenes with it right here. You can see him. It's got a cartoony feel to it, but I mean, I just love it. It's just really awesome. You know, this page right here is one of my favorite pictures in there. It's really, really cool. So, I don't want to get into it a whole lot as far as with the story, because, you know, some of you may read it, and I'm not one to spoil shit for people, so I'll just tell you it's obviously by the cover. That's Little Red Riding Hood and Big Bad Wolf, and the only other thing I can kind of tell you without spoiling anything is, you know, Grimm, that writes Grimm Fairy Tales, the one that created all of our fairy tales that usually we've read as kids, he plays a big part of this too. So yeah, definitely recommend y'all checking this out. It's been out for a couple of weeks now, so look for it. There's going to be another issue coming hopefully soon. So yeah, issue number one, Fairy Quest. Definitely check that out. next book I got, and this book right here is the reason I left comic shop that I was at and went to Heroes, because I had this on my pull list, and for some reason God didn't get it to me and decided to give it to other people there. It's Django Unchained number 2, and the story is just as good as the first one. I can't wait for the third one. I can't wait to see the movie. I'm ready for it to come out on Blu-ray so I can own it. Artwork in here is fantastic. Jason Latour drew some stuff in here too, so it's really cool. So yeah, definitely check that out. Issue number 2. There's a really cool variant cover for that too. I think you've already all seen it, so it's kind enough to pick that up for me. This one's been out for a couple weeks. This is Vampirella Strikes number 2. If this is a cover that, this is a collector's incentive cover. Had to be a subscriber to Dynamite to get these, but so only a few comic shops will get this variant, the live cover. I think I forget what her name is. It's Katana or something like that. It's a crazy name. But I've got the first one, so now I've got the second one too, so hopefully I can continue picking these up. So yeah, awesome. Beautiful cover. The story in this is really good. If you're not a Vampirella fan and wanting to jump on this is the book to do it. It's really good, so yeah, definitely check this out. And this is a new title that I'm adding to my pull list just because of the Cap Omnibus that I read back here. It's got me into this character, and this is Winter Soldier issue number 15, written by Jason Latour. Amazing book. I really love the story. It was so great. Winter Soldier is just a badass. I mean, he's a freaking beast. So yeah, y'all definitely check that out. And then the last one that he had been telling me he's going to pick up for me is a it was a tornado relief anthology that was put out for the victims here in Alabama during the very bad tornado that happened last year. Killed a lot of people, including some, it tore up the University of Alabama. I mean, it wrecked that whole place and killed quite a few of the students and stuff like that. Actually, people I knew were killed in there, and it's really sad, but all the proceeds of this book goes to helping the relief fund for those people. And yeah, so it's Country Ass-Whuppin number 1 by 12 Gauge Comics. It's nothing but short stories, and they're really freaking hilarious. The first story is written by Jason Aaron, so yeah, he's native from Alabama, so native to Alabama. So yeah, really awesome to get this, man. I really do appreciate you sending me this, and I'm not gonna take it all out of the package, but Rico Renzi, that works at the Hero Shop, did the coloring on the one of the pinups in the very back of this book. So I guess I will show it, because I want to give him his credit for that. He signed it and everything, so. On the back of the book, it's got a nice little, it was April 27th, 2011 is when that happened, so it was a little bit off. There's kind of a little story telling you about how the proceeds go to this. But here's the art that Rico colored. And he signed it right there. You can see it with my finger. I can't. Right above that guy's head. So yeah, beautiful art. And like I said, it's just a bunch of short stories, and they're really hilarious. All dealing with country redneck folks. So I know a lot of y'all northern folks may not know much about that, but that's 99% of the folks around here are country redneck people. So, but these two books he threw in just because he had extras and thought we'd. Would enjoy them, which we very much did. So King Size Hulk number 1, Frank Cho cover, freaking amazing. And issue 627 of the Incredible Hulk's, very badass cover. So that's it. Package from Ben, shooting me some comics that I was needing and stuff he had, and just. Can't say enough about the guy. He's freaking awesome. Very good close friend of mine, and couldn't ask for a better friend. So, anyways, I will probably do another video on Friday when my books get here from Heroes. So I look forward to seeing y'all's pulls tonight, and hope y'all are all doing good. Check out my last video I just did. I made that video with this new Scream and Go thing. It's hilarious. It was my take on the Marilyn Manson Beautiful People. So. You know, I had fun splicing doing that. It's the first time I ever made a video like that, so y'all check that out. Like it if you can, so it gets spread around. It's really funny. But anyways, hope y'all are having a good day, and I will talk to you soon. Take care.